decided to look at some comments when I noticed this guy right here, Mr. Blazing Up 420. He was commenting on my Egyptian astronomy is Nubian astronomy video. He mentions nothing about what I was talking about in the video. He starts off asking me if I ever heard of the Berbers of Africa. He starts talking about tattoos, which has nothing to do with anything I was saying. He starts talking about many ancient stories of Africa are found in the earliest Egyptian dynasties, some with a description of the people listing them as black and being different from them. Now, if you live in the United States of America today, you know damn well that these people just completely make up stories. They just live in a complete fantasy world. There is no many ancient stories of Africa found in the earliest Egyptian dynasties saying anything that you're talking about. You can't post anything, and we're not going to be going over that. Then he goes on to say that, I'm not sure where you got your facts, but they are incorrect. And then he goes on to say the same dumb shit that we've heard already, including the Black Madonna has nothing to do. Let me tell you guys something. If you've been on this channel, you know that I don't sit around talking about no Black Madonna. So I don't know why he's coming to me talking about Diana, some fake Greek stuff, and Black Madonna. Now, I noticed that when these guys come to my channel and try to talk to me, they always have something to say that has absolutely nothing to do with the video. But let's get back to what he was talking about with these Berbers. Whining about Berbers all the time. First of all, I don't know why these white supremacists are so obsessed with Berbers when it has nothing to do with them whatsoever. And plus, I think you're a little bit confused about Berbers. So what we're going to do right now is go back, way back, back into time. We're going to take a look at the Negro Law of South Carolina. This is a document collected and digested by one John O'Neill. As collected and digested by this John O'Neill, who's one of the judges of the courts of law and errors of the said state, under a resolution of the State Agricultural Society of South Carolina, meaning they was picking cotton. We can see right here that the undersigned was prepared as a digest of the law in relation to Negroes. All right, so what are we talking about here? On the very first page, in section 4, we see what it says. The term Negro is confined to slave Africans, the ancient Berbers, and their descendants. I repeat, the term Negro is confined to slave Africans who are the ancient Berbers and their descendants. Black people, that means you. Now, every time these people turn around, they just keep running into Negroes no matter which way they go. And this guy is so pathetic that he makes up a story and then still runs into Negroes anyway. I guess this was one of those errors of the state by Mr. John O'Neill. But you know, we've been through this already. You see, they've been playing this game for a long time where they just change their story at will. And they just continue to get away with it. And I feel like a lot of people let them get away with it. You know, they could just change their stories up constantly. And we're supposed to sit there with a straight face and accept it. Nope, you're not getting away with that here. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Here's an example of that. According to them, this is not a Negro. I was looking at this earlier when I was making the Lower Egyptian video. And I was like, bro, I cannot believe this. It says that this lady right here has little in common with the Negroid species of Africa. And this was in 1937. And they're telling us that we're the ones making up a story. Let's get back to this document, section 4. In that exact same section where it says that the term Negro was confined to slave Africans, the ancient Berbers and their descendants, it also mentions other black people. It does not embrace the free inhabitants of Africa, such as the Egyptians, the Moors, or the Negro Asiatics, such as Indians. Here, an Indian is a Negro Asiatic, and then they go on mentioning Egyptians and Moors, and this is all in the same section as Negroes, slave Africans, and ancient Berbers, and their descendants. And it's like, there's no way they can get around this. Once again, I want to know, why do you guys keep changing your story? Now let's move on to this freak right here, who comes to me on my video where I'm over here talking about Nigeria, and then he tells me there is no evidence of fractal use in sub-Saharan Africa. Never mind the fact that I literally showed it right there on the video. Now, this is what you call that cognitive dissonance, because all you got to do is just type African fractals into any search engine, and all kinds of stuff like that is going to come up, and you could just read about it for hours upon hours. Still, this guy comes to my channel and tells me there's no evidence of fractal use in sub-Saharan Africa, and that's just him exercising his own feelings. He got to get them demons out. But you're not going to punish me. What's going to happen is your punishment will continue. This stuff is so easy to find. You can find this TED Talk right here. It has nearly 1.8 million views, and it's not even on YouTube. Okay? 1.8 million people want to hear about African fractals, and this guy comes to me and tells me there's no evidence of African fractals in sub-Saharan Africa. You got this guy going to people's houses. This is a mathematician going to African families so he can stand on their roof and study African fractals. Just as many people wanted to watch that as wanted to see the oldest living things, stuff about outer space. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. So I just wanted to go over real quick how these people, they just completely make up a story. They really just tell themselves whatever makes them feel better about their lives, but that is not my job. I'm not here to babysit your feelings.